Rocky say hello to Ryan Leslie. Ryan, the Flames back home following that 3-1 road trip that wrapped up on Monday in Chicago. For you, what stood out to you about the team's performance?
You know what, Jackie? I think just the fact that when you watch those games fairly closely, you realize they really didn't play their best. And, you know, you look at teams, at good teams, they find ways to win. And that's kind of the theme of that road trip anyhow. Their best game that they played was against Boston. They didn't win that game, and they managed to grind out some games against some teams that, who, albeit of struggling, I mean, Chicago turned things around. Detroit and Philadelphia, we know they've had better seasons. But just the fact that even when things aren't going, you got a long road trip right after the holidays. I mean, we all left on January 1st, bound for Detroit. Happy New Year. But it was one of those road trips where you knew you had to probably come back with 5, maybe 6 of a possible 8 points. They did that. They came back with 6. So you'll take it. You know that Bill Peters has been preaching a lot about getting some practice time and how important that is for him. So now he's going to have it. 5-game homestand here for Calgary, and it'll start tonight against the Avalanche. But that was kind of the theme, to be honest with you.
Well, it's well documented that a lot of the Flames' success this season has come from the likes of Johnny Hockey, Sean Monahan, and Elias Lindholm, that top line that I just mentioned off of the top. Let's throw Matthew Tkachuk in there as well. What stat for you stands out about this quartet, let's say?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. I think everybody around these parts is talking about the fact that you've got 4 guys with 50-plus points. At this point in the season, that hasn't been done since 95-96. You go back to those Pittsburgh teams, it would be Francis, Sandstrom, Jagr, Lemieux. It hasn't been done at this point in the season. And so for Calgary to do it and have 4 guys with 50-plus points, they are really working. Tkachuk gets in there on the power play. I mean, that Lindholm deal was just one that they obviously love.
Yeah, that's worked out, huh?
Yeah, it really has. And so, I mean, the trade has worked out. And, I mean, everybody's talking about the way Johnny's playing. He's in that heart conversation legitimately now. And he is feeling it. He gets, you know, asked about it everywhere he goes. And so do his player, his teammates, and so do his coaches. So this is a little bit of momentum. We haven't seen anything like that in these parts in some time. So when you start looking at the numbers, they got 168 points as a trio. And I think right now what Colorado has is 175, if I'm not mistaken. And so 2 top lines in the National Hockey League going ahead. They will see some time against one another tonight. So it should be a lot of fun.
Well, the points certainly speak for themselves with that line and with Johnny Gaudreau. EJ was saying off the top of the show, for him, he is certainly a heart candidate. You just mentioned it yourself. Why do you think he has such a strong case as someone that watches him night in, night out?
Yeah, he's really elevated his game, Jackie, in a way that good players, great players do. And Bill Peters this morning was talking about the fact that a lot of it, the change, the biggest change, we all know he's had offense and creativity and great hands and great feet, but a lot of it's come defensively. Now, he's not saying this guy is going to, you know, be the best defensive forward on the ice, but he has added that wrinkle, which means the puck is on his stick a lot more. And that has led to him getting out of zones. It has led to him entering the zone. Mark Giordano told me the other day that there's just something in Boston. He said, you know, there's just something about the way he's anticipating now that is off the charts. That's what's leading to all these breakaways. And he said, if I was a defenseman trying to stop Johnny Gaudreau these days, I'd be terrified because of the way he's going about it. So I think that kind of sums up the way Johnny Gaudreau's playing.
Well, Ryan, we can't talk about this Flames team without talking a little bit about David Rittich. I mean, my goodness, what a story, yeah. Especially considering Mike Smith has been struggling this season. Is Calgary a team that could be looking to add another goaltender as we approach the trade deadline?
It's kind of a fascinating conversation, one that maybe goes back to the one you were just having before I joined you. Just, you know, David Rittich, who's going to make his 3rd start tonight, has got some type of comparables to the way Mika Kiprusoff came in that kind of unheralded. Not a lot of people know a lot about him, kind of quietly bursting on the scene. You'll remember Kiprusoff was a 3rd string goalie in San Jose before Daryl Sutter and the Flames acquired him. Daryl knew. Well, people feel they know something about David Rittich in these parts, but they've watched him now, albeit a sample size. It's just this season. He was good as a backup last year. But when Mike Smith came on, was injured, rather, and David Rittich came on in relief last year, that starter label didn't fit. This is a fun-loving, jovial guy. His teammates love him, and he's sort of embraced Not that a lot of people are painting him with that number one brush, but he is the number one goaltender right now. And Smith needs to try to find his game. So that question you asked, you know, if they were to go out, what does that look like? They still have Mike Smith under contract. And is whatever they go out and get going to be better? Is it a backup? Is it a starter? You've got an interesting dynamic as far as a goaltending situation is concerned. I really think at the end of the day, this is what you'll see, barring any unfortunate incident. I think you're going to see David Riddick and Mike Smith down the stretch. Well, it's early, but we'll see.
Yeah, it's an interesting question. I guess the Flames still have about 6.5 weeks to try to figure out what their answer is for it. Ryan, I'm going to put you on the spot here a little bit. I got to ask how your neck's doing, because I saw you doing this report over the weekend in Philly.
Yes.
And I got to say, I feel like you probably knew Gritty was going to get in the mix here, but he was a little aggressive.
You know what? I taunted him earlier and paid a price, Jackie, as you do. Ask anybody in studio, anybody around this game, they'll tell you, sometimes you have to answer the bell, and I did, and I had it coming, and it's a little sore, but we'll be okay.
Yes, you're doing well, you're playing through it, and we appreciate that here at NHL Network.
It's the National Hockey League, it's an everyday league, Jackie, I don't need to tell you
yeah,
that.
Yeah, this ain't the NBA, we play through injury over here. Listen, Ryan, enjoy the game tonight, I hope you feel better, and thanks for
this,
we appreciate it.
Anytime, guys.